1930 had arrived on the railway. However, the engines noticed a bit more construction, specifically past Kelsthorpe Road. This was due to a branch line being constructed. It would be called the Kirk Ronan branch line. More freight trains had been scheduled on the line, and two engines had been purchased ahead of time to help. This was Jinty, a Fowler 3F, and Eric, a larger tank engine. One morning at Wellsworth, Jinty and Eric were talking to Edward.
"I must say, I can't wait for the branch line to be completed."
"Indeed, I can't wait to pull passengers along the line."
"I know it must be exciting. Although, Eric, you still have quite a bit to learn. You were only built 2 months ago."
"Will do. Although, who will help with the freight? I assume you'll do it, Jinty."
"Nope, I have to shunt at the docks. I believe I've been instructed with that." "Winston, is that you? I haven't seen you since 1923.
Who's this?"
"I'm Winston. I used to work trains to Vickerstown during the war, but I slept at Barrow."
"Well, where did you go after that?"
"Well, I worked in the Midlands for a while with freight trains, although Sir Topham Hatt had contacted my railway about purchasing me for freight work on this new branch line."
"Well, that's wonderful. Hopefully we don't get you and James confused."
"Who's James?"
"Oh, well, here he comes now."
"I don't believe it."
"We look almost alike."
"It'll be nice to have another red engine in the fleet."
"Although there was that one time you were painted blue, Winston."
"I much prefer this splendid red to any old blue."
"Splendid red. I like it." "Anyways, I'd best help James up the hill. It was nice seeing you again, Winston."
"Nice seeing you too, Edward." Edward went to go help James up the hill. Jinty and Eric had also left, and Winston got turned around to head down the Brendan branch. When he arrived, he found Colin and Adam sitting in the sheds.
"Well, I'll be. It is you, Winston. Long time no see."
"Hello, you two. It's been ages."
"Indeed. It's good to see you. I almost thought it was James."
"Yes, I met him. He seems like a nice engine."
"Say, is Lily still..."
"So, she's still angry with me?"
"Yes, she is. Although, we know you didn't cause that incident on purpose."
"I know. Anyways, I was meant to pick up a train of supplies for the construction of this new branch.
It should be over there in the sidings."
"Well, I'll go get it now. Nice to see you again, you two."
Winston left to go collect his freight train. Meanwhile, on the Kirk Ronan branch, Jinty and Eric were sitting in the sheds having a discussion.
"It all looks like it's coming together nicely."
"Indeed. I heard one of the workmen say it'll be done in 2 weeks' time."
"Wow, that's pretty quick."
"Hold on, I just had a thought. What coaching stock will I be using?"
"Maybe some old coaching stock from the main line."
"Maybe there are some in the carriage sheds over there."
"Good idea. I'll go check over there now."
Jinty left the sheds to go over to the carriage sheds.
"Oh, goodness gracious! What a horrible bump! Watch what you're doing, you clumsy shunter!"
"Steady on. I didn't bump you that hard."
"Yes, you did, you reckless shunter."
"I beg your pardon."
"Don't beg. It makes you look pathetic."
"Oh, that's it. I'll bump you straight through the..."
"What's going on here?"
"It's these coaches. They're the ones starting a problem."
"We are not! This clumsy fool!" I've heard enough from you. Now listen here, I'm sure Jinty didn't bump you as hard as you say.
But!
Now, will you quit this behavior?
Fine, we'll drop it.
Good. I hope we can...
That doesn't sound good.
I hope you're right, Jinty. Unfortunately, the storm would only worsen. A bad storm had hit the line, and it made visibility very poor. To add to that, construction on the branch line was slowed down. Thankfully, the weather had cleared up and was reduced to a drizzle, and work on the branch continued. Finally, it was ready.
All right, you three. Despite what the weather may seem like, today is going to be an excellent day.
Let's hope so, sir.
Now, Eric, you will have the first train of the day. You'll go straight to Kelstorp Road with it. However, that's not how all services will run. You will have to stop at Rolf's Castle, too. However, since this is the grand opening run, I want you to make a straight shot to Kelstorp Road.
Yes, sir. Let's hope the weather doesn't impede us in our work.
Sir Topham Hatt walked away as the engines got ready for the day's work. Soon the coaches were arranged. Eric blew his whistle and set off. However, as Eric passed the signal box, it began to pour.
Oh, not now. I'm so close to making it up this hill.
However, as Eric neared the top, he eventually came to a stop.
Oh, come on. We were doing so well.
We'll need to see if someone can help us up the hill.
Eventually, Winston arrived to help push the train.
Need some help, youngster?
Funny. Just get me up the hill.
Winston moved forward to help bank the train up the hill. As Eric went over the hill, he found it hard to stop due to the rain. Eric was glad that he was able to stop. Eric reversed back to the station so the passengers could get off. Sir Topham Hatt came to address the engines in the evening.
Are you all right, Eric?
Yes, sir. I'm just a bit shaken up.
That's understandable. However, apart from that incident, it seems passenger services will perform well. I can't wait to see what goods traffic brings as well. I know you three won't let me down on your performance on this branch line. Good night.
Sir Topham Hatt walked away, leaving the three engines to talk late into the evening. He was confident that the engines wouldn't let him down, and that the branch line would perform successfully.